Life is all about opportunities. If you don't ever stop and grab one, they may just fly by and never come back.
I'll try and keep the light low so you can see. It's about 6 a.m. right now, time for breakfast. You got the old skillet with the steak and eggs. I didn't have a spatula, so I'm kind of cooking it all with this little multi-tool thing.
Pete, how are we doing over here?
I need you to get duct tape. This thing's leaking, seriously.
Duct tape in the bottom drawer, Peter. Get a headlamp, too, while you're at it.
Duct tape.
Where the fuck is the duct tape?
God
damn it. Got shit everywhere.
It's in here.
No, it's not.
Why the fuck?
Come on.
You know, we're talking about some missing repairs right now.
You got dial at 6 a.m. I'm trying to sleep. Now I'm up.
This is fucking in this spot, dude. This is raw protein, too, dude. Steak and egg. Come on.
Is that the ones from,
It's fucking mint. Shit.
You got a lot of people behind us?
They can wait. They'll be alright. No rush.
Good morning, Valentina. Gracias.
Hey, how's it going? This thing's
just
not taking my card.
Your credit card or your ticket?
No, my debit card. It just doesn't, it's not reading at some reason.
Okay, one moment. Let me see what's going on
with
that night. One moment, sir.
Got a lot on my plate here. I just tried that. I got nothing.
It says it's processing, sir. Give it just a moment.
Oh, damn.
Card accepted.
Thanks.
Thank you.
We're out of here. Thank you.
Hey, me and Pete have been doing the graveyard shift this whole time, right? So get off our back. Alright, well, my name is Kyle Mackey, 22 years old, grew up here in New York, just graduated college from University of Tampa. This is my child, his name's Otto the Schnauzer. He's a little nervous right now, he's camera shy.
What kind of bike are you riding right now?
2015 Yamaha YZ125. Just picked her up about a month ago, dialed her in. She's not great, but I think it should last. Well, I just graduated college, taking a little year off, get my shit together, relax, make some money. So right now we bought an RV with the boys. We're gonna travel around for a month. I think we're gonna hit most states out on the West Coast, some riding. He's not coming with us because he's gonna be annoying the whole time. But yeah, we got bought an RV. We're gonna have a good time. So hopefully the overall goal is the RV makes it home at the end. All right, but yeah, we're gonna go out west. We're gonna hit some sand dunes. We're gonna hit some riding out in Moab, Bonneville Salt Flats, top it out. And overall goal is just see the country, have a good time with the friends. Yeah, I expect just about everything to break. If this bike doesn't blow up and the motor doesn't pop on the RV, I'd consider that a win. Anything else, we'll deal with it. Pretty handy, we're bringing a couple tools here. There.
Dude, I asked my lady, and I'm like, what's skater doing? She goes,
better cooling,
better cooling. That's exactly what I was just.
You know what? So when we're low on oil, it won't overheat because it just constantly has a flow of airflow.
Airflow and beautiful. Bitches, too. Shit.
Beautiful.
Well,
you go in that middle drawer, grab my tape.
We got some weather coming.
Woo-wee! Down in the storm, brother!
Hold on, let me take a second and put my tooth in. Alright, now we're ready. I'm Brandon Murphy, 24, going on a trip. going all over the country. We're gonna ride, see some nice, you know, some nice landmarks, all that type of stuff.
Yeah. Where are we trying to end up?
Glamis Sand Dunes, out in California, all the way out west.
Do you expect anything to go wrong or anything to break?
Positive thinker.
All right, man, I like that.
Very positive thinker.
I like that. I like your bike too, man.
Thank you. It's not even mine. I stole it.
Oh, wait. All right, that's one way to fucking do it. Yeah, fuck it. We don't need that shit.
I need it right at the stop sign.
Pete, how you feeling, man?
Horrible.
I'm Pete from New Jersey, born and raised out now in New York. We bought a shitbox RV on the side of the road in New Jersey. Packed her up, dialed her in, got about 12 bikes heading out west. Going to Cali, Wyoming. Back up, drop. And just kind of winging life, man. I don't know. We're all unemployed. Dropped out of school. I got thrown out of school. We're just kind of winging it from here. Dirt bikes, getting laid. All the above, man. Whatever the hell we can get ourselves into. You know, sandboard, chicks, shit.
So you expect anything to go wrong or break?
Of course, yeah. Someone's bike's gonna pop, trans might go on the RV. It's a four with 150K, so we all know. Got found on road dead, so at some point that bitch is gonna be fucking sitting there. We got the headlamps, we're prepared for it, so it should go.
Yeah, all I was saying is that now that we're living in the rig, we're basically our own society for about a month. We're detached from everything else, and there's no rules here, okay? Sit back and enjoy the ride.
Yeah. J-Mills, you're a late addition to the trip, right? Where?
Yeah, dude.
Why?
Fucking... Oh, man. You really want to know how we got
into this? Yeah, how did you get sucked into this, what you thought was a two-week trip, and now it's a month trip?
Nah, they told me they needed a mechanic. I told him I know how to fix shit.
Hold on.
Pete?
Hold on. I got a
good
idea.
All right, well, we've been camping out in front of Kyle's front yard for the past 2 days. It's been a little rough. We are going somewhere in the United States. We are going to be cruising around in our beautiful RV. The thing's mint. We have absolutely no idea where we're going, if we're going to be completely honest with you. At least I don't. I wasn't informed. I expect every single thing here to break. I expect absolutely not anything to go right whatsoever. If this thing makes it out there, I'm going to be completely shocked.
So Dan, what's the goal of the entire trip when we get home? What?
To not get STDs. The ultimate goal of this trip, honest to God, is to rip my two smoker like there's no tomorrow and take my race quad out and find some girls, if I'm gonna be completely honest with you.
Safety first.
Dude, I mean, that pass is good for a year.
That's true, we'll come back next year.
Oh, we might be able to see it.
Featuring a Pabst Blue Ribbon.
We should have brought more shock.
All right, boys, what do you think of Mount Rushmore right now?
It's beautiful. Gorgeous.
Bring the camera on. Show me what cooking was.
Beautiful. What a fucking rush.
Oh, dude. Awesome. Mount Rushmore looks great this time of year.
Oh,
never seen such a thing.
Beautiful.
It's like a mix of New Jersey and Staten Island.
Absolutely gorgeous.
Place is crawling with bitches too.
We went right to Colorado and just rode.
Can see a dog's ass.
Yeah, was that it right there?
Oh. 34 hours, Kyle.
2 hours.
Kyle, what do you think of this, man?
She's so excited to see Mount Rushmore.
She said we won't be able to see it right now.
Technically,
away.
We're looking.
Yeah, we're looking right at Mount Rushmore.
Man, what a tough ride that first leg was all the way out to Mount Rushmore. 35 hours, pretty much straight through to get there, and it'd be too foggy to see anything. Fortunately, that happens in life. Sometimes you do a whole lot, you work hard, you push for stuff, and you just fall short. And that's okay. You know, it's better to have the solid knowing that something didn't work than to have that what if and regret not trying it. You know, we could have just ignored going to Mount Rushmore and said, nah, it's all right, it's too far out of the way. But instead, we tried pursuing it. We tried to go actually see what was going on. And, you know, we got there. And unfortunately, due to things we couldn't control, we weren't able to see it. And that happens. There's tons of
outside sources that make things unachievable in life, and that's just a sad reality.
Peep. About to get yelled at by the cops.
Watch.
Peep out over there.
No.
Yeah.
We're on the wrong side of the road.
Does he know that we're from Staten Island?
He's literally sitting right there.
Just wave at him.
Wait, does he know we're from Staten Island? That's how we roll.
Yeah, no, just let him know, dude. We're from Staten Island. My fucking girl and her pussy. Yeah, no, I'm sorry. The trailer brakes blew out. I think the wiring. So we just don't want to be driving around here with no lights and stuff in the back.
Yeah,
so
we're just replacing
it. Just getting those figured out. Yeah,
we have the part.
We should be done in 15 minutes. Sounds good. All right. Thanks, officer. Appreciate it.
Backup lights.
Dude, I told them that I know how to fix shit, so I go on this trip for free.
Let me see this.
No, I don't know how to fix shit. Alright, no more backup lights, so forget about it.
Figured out all the wiring harness I needed to cut. Wires, extend wires, test wires. But trailer lights finally fucking work. Only took 2 hours, and then we popped another fuse. We gotta run to the gas station to get that. Going from Mount Rushmore through Wyoming to Colorado was such a headache. Trailer lights blew out about an hour into the drive. We pulled into the only town within a 200-mile radius, and thankfully they had the part to fix the lights, even though it took 3 hours to actually get the wires back together. Continuing the drive down, we didn't realize we had a blowout on the trailer and proceeded to drive 100 miles on three wheels and a rim.
Hills. Yeah, we're looking for the hill. Everybody's going to the hill tonight.
We found a park.
Picture like a red carpet event, but like Colorado style.
It's in a couple.
And we talked to some fellow students.
Dude, hold on, listen. Everybody.
Wait, actually, we need jumper cables, dude.
No, dude. There's one
generator.
There's one place everyone's going to out here in Boulder. It's the fucking hills.
We're on the hill.
No, not the fucking hill. It's called the hills.
The hill.
Like it's a bar, you go out, drink, try and get
couple ones.
Fucking throw them back with your boys, kick back, relax, have a smoke, enjoy yourself.
Have jumper cable.
Take a load off.
Colorado is currently on fire. There's like six big different mountains on fire. Not good at all.
Man, what a weird day it's been. We're in Boulder this morning. We woke up, we drove an hour north to Fort Collins. Got some dirt bike parts overnighted. The parts guy ended up ordering the wrong year. So we took the whole bike apart to get the wrong part. And now I still have a broken dirt bike. Parts got overnighted to Moab in Utah. So hopefully tomorrow morning when we get there, my parts will be waiting for us so we can actually ride. It's definitely sometimes just look out the window, take a deep breath, and just take the view in. And you realize that sometimes just the little problems you have in life are just as little as they seem. And that there's a huge world out there.
Welcome to Utah, boys!
Boys, welcome to Utah!
Maybe we can actually ride in this thing.
Pull over and get it. I like it out here.
Dude, it's so sick.
Welcome to Utah, boys!
Dude, the rig looks sick over here.
Utah was probably the first sense of a winning day we've had. My parts came in. Everybody was in a good mood. Nothing broke on the RV. We finally were able to get out there and put some hours on our dirt bike. Beautiful thing about being out west is that you can just pull over to the side of the road and you can ride anywhere you want. There's no laws. There's no restrictions. And everybody's kind of on the same page out there.
Turn your magic on. To me, she'd say,
cool for a while now.
Holy shit!
Here, hold this.
Yeah, if you go
off
of
that, yeah. Stop! 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 Fuck! Boys, what are you guys thinking right now?
Dude, it's beautiful.
Worth the ride up here?
If our girls find out we're up here, it's fucking game over, bro. No fucking bullshit. Fucking, my fucking thing's leaking. Oh,
shit. Here, let me get my bike.
Right. I got you. Not bad. It's a nice place. My toe hurt for a little bit, but we're good.
How we feeling right now, buddy?
Fantastic, bro.
Yeah, man, what do you think of the view?
On top of the fucking world right now.
You ever get that feeling that you're just on top of the world? Everything's going right. All your work is starting to pay off. And all the problems you had have gone away. Luckily, that's kind of what it felt like when we finally made it to the top of this trail. The Top of the World Trail is one of the most famous trails in Moab and one of the toughest terrains for off-roading there is. After 3 hours of hard riding, overheating bikes, we finally made it to the top. Honestly, well, I wasn't expecting this kind of view. And when we got to the top, we literally felt like we were at the top of the world. We saw hundreds of miles in the distance in a 360 degree radius. And it was by far the craziest view any of us have ever seen. Sometimes in life, you gotta just go out and go back to your roots. Do the things you love doing and the things that have brought you happiness in the past. And all of your problems for that few minutes will certainly go away.
Well,
John, we definitely went the wrong fucking way. We went way too wide.
Should have went left. We went right.
We're
in some
fucked.
Real soft sand right
now, boys.
Oh,
shit.
All right. Well, we came out to the Salt Flats this morning. Got up real early to get out of the snow in Salt Lake. And we could not find it for the life of us. Took a right down this sandy trail. And the rig is just buried. We've got, you know, 14-foot trailer behind it. And we're just, I mean, you can see how sandy this is. It's a mess. Pete's doing a great, I give Pete props. He's doing a great job.
Yo, guys, you guys gotta shut the door and watch out.
Peter's a little stressed out. I mean, we're all a little stressed out. It's okay. Actually, we're on the trail. We're moving again. We were buried.
There she goes.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
Straight.
You got that ramp. That ramp saved our life today. It's a little bent up.
Yo, can Pete turn around on this? This is hard pass. Peter, this is hard pass.
We just don't know. Pete, give her the balls, baby. Drop it down low. Yeah. Wait. Yeah, you're dug in now. You're gonna need some sticks or something.
Oh wait, that's not his.
No, I should've done the whole way. I saw it.
Hey, listen, we took a risk. It didn't pay off. We're gonna get out.
The problem is, I have no power right now.
Put a fucking jackknife in the fuck at it.
Wait, it's hitting, bro.
No,
look at the bottom. No,
it's hitting.
Literally the smallest.
It's in there. It's hitting.
What? We're all right. guess what? All right, we tried to maneuver
Brandon's
and we failed.
Disgust. He's like, no. Nope.
Tried to maneuver and it didn't work out.
You gotta spend money to make money. You gotta gamble a little bit, life.
We fucking gambled.
We took a gamble. And guess what? We are getting on the salt flats today.
We are not. We are getting on the salt flats.
I am not leaving.
The fucking ring is. The fucking ring is fucking stuck.
Boys.
Fucking
up this time. It's funny because like this is a really bad situation. We are miles into the Utah desert right now, looking for these salt flats that we couldn't find, and we're all just giggling about it, man. You gotta have this here,
right?
This is so bad. Woo! Pete, you want?
Did you turn off that?
You guys go give her hell!
No!
I fucking laid her down and here we fucking are!
Why didn't we just back it up? We were on the fucking trail!
We took a risk and it didn't pay off.
Holy shit, dude!
I can't go anymore!
Oh, fuck, dude. Here's the wiring job. Check this out, Kyle.
I mean, we can just go riding right now.
You want me to actually take the 125 out and go to town and see if I can figure it out?
What is that gonna do?
Maybe someone there has a UTV. He'll tell them to come yank us out. We'll pay him $100.
Dude, you think a UTV is getting this thing out?
Bro, it'll help. Dude, no. He'll show up with a shovel, a UTV. We'll give him $100, $200 and he'll pull us out. What else are we gonna do, dude?
Start fucking digging. Everyone needs to dig. Get the back tires.
Another update. We are really fucking buried now, man. Changed my goggles out. The other ones were getting sand in my eyes. We've got stuff laying around all over. We tried everything, jacking it up, digging it out. And as you can see, it's completely buried. The trailer's hitting the rig at the top. I mean, what we're looking at right now is calling a tow truck company and they're trying to charge us $1,500 to come pull us out. It's gonna be a disaster. One wrong turn, $1,500. Wasn't a smart idea.
After 6 hours, our rescue is here. There he is. Beautiful. How are ya? Yeah, we're a little stuck.
The rig is here. The Ski-Dozer 252, baby.
Got the reinforcements here. They brought this big freaking thing with tracks on it. And these two guys, they're really nice guys. They don't speak much English, but they're very nice. Problem is they tried to pull us out backwards first and they were struggling, jackknifing the trailer, about to snap the axles.
Yeah, I heard Jay Mills, like I think it was fucking earlier. He's like, fuck dude, I should have just flown out of Wyoming or something. Really wants to get out of my
shit. Dude, I mean, we're having a good time other than the blowing cash aspect. We had a budget for this that we put into an account together and we are
this is the only
we blew it apart in the first week. Come on, Jamie.
Pull the rig! Let her eat! Come on, Johnny!
Thank you.
I begin with this day? To start, none of us had any idea where the Bonneville Salt Flats actually were. Looking at the map, I thought it was down this graded dirt road about 25 miles off the highway, and we all agreed that that was it. So we proceeded to drive and drive and drive. 3 hours later, we got to the end to realize that the Bonneville Salt Flats was nowhere to be found. On the way back in, we took a different road to see if the flats were at the end of this specific road. Well, we fucked up. We fucked up big time. We got the RV stuck, a 45-foot rig down an ATV path, stuck in the sand. After about 20 minutes of digging and working, we finally were able to get the RV out and proceeded to back it up down the trail we came. Unfortunately, we thought it was a bright idea to just try to make a U-turn over what we thought was kind of hard-packed sand. Turned out to be really soft, powdery sand. This turned into a disaster. RV bottomed out. After about 6 hours of trying to dig the RV out and try to free it, we finally gave up. We figured out that there was one tow truck company in the entire area that would be willing to drive 25 miles into the middle of the desert with a Bobcat and pull us out. As you could tell, it took a lot of effort to get this rig out of this fucking sand pit. By far, the most stressed I was the entire trip. Everybody loves stressing me out even more than they always do.
Oh yeah, these are my favorite pants ever. Fruity McGee.
Making smart with the words again. Well, I'm bored, well, I'm old, well, I'm bored, well, I'm bored. Because I'm doing this for the thrill of it, killing it, never not chasing a million things I want. I am only as young as the minute is full of it, getting bumped up on the little bright things I want. But I know they'll never own me.
What'd you do?
Can you ride it back? I blew the bead off. I need a lighter.
Poke it.
I gotta pee really bad.
Oh, dude, it's so hot. It's like burn your skin hot.
Are you serious?
We could probably go in this thing. Go for a dip.
Oh,
dude,
I don't
even know what I'm doing with these pictures.
Oh, that is real buffalo.
Would you
that is
believe,
real
God, would you believe it? I stepped in buffalo poop.
So sometimes some of the most unknown places are the best kept secrets. That's where the St. Anthony sand dunes kind of came in. in the middle of Idaho, where it's hundreds of acres of farmland. You're driving through the middle of what you would never expect to be one of the craziest days of riding we had. The sand dunes were just all untouched, perfectly smooth sand. We were able to camp right next to the sand dunes, had a nice fire. Fortunately, at night, got to about 15 degrees, and we didn't realize that our heat wasn't working, so we froze our asses off. But the next day kind of made it worth it. We headed up towards Yellowstone, where we were able to see some of the really cool hot springs that we've never seen before, and take in some views that are unlike anything we have here on the East Coast.
Up in the middle of nowhere. Shit.
Well, long story short, I got indigestion and I think Dan blew the motor.
Dan, ask him, is it a possibility, since it's so hot you need to run a different oil?
Yeah, Dion, is it a possibility that it's so hot out that you have to run a different oil in it?
Ask him if the oil thinned out and that's the reason why.
Glamis sand dunes. Man, the entire trip was pretty much built around getting to this one place. Just like in life, after all your hiccups, all your ups and downs, all the problems, things that went wrong, sometimes if you keep that one idea in your head of what you want to do and where you want to achieve,
it'll come true. In our case, it's this. After the RV getting stuck in the salt flats, many tires blowing out, the walls getting ripped off the floor of the RV, fights, arguments, getting lost, mountains being on fire, and about 8,000 miles of driving, we finally made it to the Glamis Sand Dunes. Some of our biggest and longest goals since we were kids was to ride dirt bikes in these sand dunes. They're known for their crazy hill climbs, huge jumps, and outrageous views. Luckily enough, nobody really got hurt. Unfortunately for Dan, well, he managed to blow his bike up. Which is kind of ironic because Dan had the newest motor out of all of us. Had about 4 hours on it, and he spent the most too. Sorry, Dan.
Well, boys, we made it to Mexico.
Hey, I'll say balls and oysters.
Maybe we can ask him for a photo.
We're about to get yelled at by the Border Patrol.
Boys are getting yelled at.
Yeah, heads up, Brandon.
Dude, we're definitely going to get yelled at. What are you going to do?
Whatever.
How's it going, guys?
How are ya?
Chance, dude, could you get one photo of him?
But I mean, could you get a photo?
Can you park behind it?
Way somewhere. We gotta go.
Oh, all right, no problem. No thanks, though, guys.
Be safe, guys.
Could you get a photo of all of us? I need to be a real pain, but I'm gonna
go.
Hey, I'll take a
look. Oh, you're the fuck.
So what's the EP cruiser out over here?
Yeah, we just chase people.
That's fucking great.
So I wanted to see the Mexican border because, you know, this is like a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity over here, you know, because before Trump builds the new wall. So this is looking beautiful over here. We got to see some Border Patrol. Some dude's hiding in the bushes staring at us. It's a good time.
Dude! We just told Border Patrol not to worry about it.
Because they shouldn't.
Don't worry about it.
We talked to the other guy already.
Get you down to the first level, because the fourth level, everything goes up, prices, everything.
Oh yeah, I appreciate that. Okay. Sir, thank you.
Give me a couple minutes, I'll get you out of here.
Now, no question, there's no court date, right?
Court date?
Yeah. Court date? No court
date.
There dates.
Will be, but you don't have to go, and I'll.
You can just plead not guilty, well, or guilty.
Take,
I mean,
you can do whatever you want, but.
Brandon. 94 and a 55.
Damn it.
Shit. I knew it, dude. I knew.
What's life without mistakes? I couldn't tell you. So, the two dads were rocking one Polaris, myself and Brandon. And, unfortunately, we got caught doing something we weren't supposed to. You know, we got our consequences. Brandon got a ticket for doing 94 and 55 on the highway. I guess that's the price you pay for having fun. I mean, we knew we were in the wrong. We pulled right over. The cop was nice about it, so But you make mistakes in life, and that's the way it is. As long as you learn from it and you keep moving forward, put your best foot forward.
Dude, I knew that. Guys know where to park and spend the night.
Nah, just visiting.
We're heading out, yeah. This is cool. It's really cool, though.
You got a place open for banana splits and hamburgers.
Oh, yeah?
Right up the road, just before the range on the right.
All
right. The main intersection is the church, the blue church on the left. Go through that intersection going east, and you'll see lights. They're on because they're open on Tuesdays.
Oh, perfect. Okay. Really cool. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Good banana splits. Good price. I'm gonna level up, bless you. It's all good. Leonard, a guy Leonard Knight built this. A guy named Ron, which is like his shadow. He's the caretaker now. So when you guys go, just have the mask on. Mm-hmm. Back in the late 70s, he was from the East Coast, and he was drinking and driving, and he got in a car accident and killed his family, his whole family, his wife and his children. So he's like, well, fuck, like. I want to start over, you know. So he bought a hot air balloon, and he's like, oh, I'll go to Brazil, like Che Rivera, you know what I mean? Like trying to start over type of stuff. So that's what he did. He bought a hot air balloon and he started flying from the east, from New Jersey, and then he got to this point, and he was up way up there, right? And his balloon popped and he crash lands, boom, right here, boom, right. He barely lives. He barely makes right. And then so he's like, well, okay, then I'll get a job and fix up this balloon. And I'll keep it moving, you know. And I don't know. Couple of days later, God came to him in the night and says, Leonard, I need you to do something for me. And he's like, well, I need you to build it for me. Build it so they can come. And Leonard's like, build what? Just build it for me. Build it so they can come. And he just started building. And that's made out of hay and straw and mud.
Hey Kyle, what do you think of this place?
This is cool. Really incredible. One guy built it. I wish we could go inside, but or climb up it, but either way, just seeing it's really cool. It's in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
You see all the hay?
Excited, man.
First balloon jump.
First balloon.
No.
Jump. Love you guys, all right?
All right. Are you guys ready?
Five, two, one, go.
See you guys.
Yeah, well, fuck yeah.
Go. See you guys. Hot air balloon in the books. Time to land this thing, buddy. Woo! Woo! Aha! Woo! Yeah, buddy! That's better than any cup of coffee you can ever drink, man.
So basically we were getting the RV ready to go. It was the first day of the trip in front of my house. Got a random Instagram follow from this guy named Justice and his production company, which was out of Los Angeles, California. So I gave him a follow back and shot him a random DM. I said, hey, we're gonna be in LA in about 2 weeks with some dirt bikes and parachutes if you wanna get together. And he said, yeah, sure. figured nothing would come of it, but about a week later, he messaged me back. He said, hey, you want to do a balloon jump? He said, I know a guy who can set it up. I said, for sure. I told all the boys if they wanted to come for a ride, they could. I've gotten the balloon by 6 a.m. Met some really cool guys. Justice was the guy who I talked to on Instagram. Then we had Albie, who's a really well-known helicopter pilot out there. We had this guy, Dean, who was on The Bachelor, and a couple other really cool guys. Basically, yeah, we went up in the hot air balloon, my first time, all the boys' first time. A little bit intimidating, a little bit scary, but all worked out well. Landed safely, and it's one for the books, for sure.
I think where I wanted to go was that one. You climb up the background side of that.
Wow.
I'm way too drunk to stay.
Jimmo.
So that was it. Yosemite was our last stop on the trip before making the 45-hour drive back home. Looking back at it, I'm really fortunate I took that opportunity. Initially, the trip was just going to be Kyle on his own. He wanted to take his Jeep and go cross country. He invited me out, and I kept kind of pushing it aside because I didn't necessarily want to take off work or if I could manage it with school or whatnot. But then he asked Pete and Dan, and they got on board for the trip. And they kept pushing the opportunity on me even more. And I was in a very big dilemma. Do I take the opportunity to travel the country with my friends, put life aside for a month, and really do all the things we said we were gonna do for the past 3 years? Or do I push it off to another time that might not ever be there? So we did it. 1 month exactly, leaving on October 15th, came back on November 15th. You know, everything was going against us. We all had work or school that we had to deal with. We had an RV that was falling apart on us. People saying that the RV wouldn't even make it to California. A global pandemic that just so happened to spruce everything up. Wildfires in Colorado, fog at Mount Rushmore, stuck in the Bonneville Salt Flats for a day. Everything was going against us, but we saw this opportunity and we all pushed forward. We took the opportunity. We didn't let anything stop us. Life's not about the opportunities you take, but regretting the ones that you didn't. And that's one thing myself and my best friends can say, is that we never let an opportunity like this pass us. Because we know at the end of our life, we're only gonna remember these things that we regretted not doing. And I'm 100% thankful that I took this opportunity that was presented in front of me and made some memories that not only I will remember, but I know my friends will remember for the rest of our lives.